Thanks for clicking on WMUR.com. I'm meteorologist Eric Weglars. A beautiful day outside, a lot of sunshine, really nice day. First day, it feels like in forever where we've seen the sun for more than, say, 3 or 4 hours. Temperatures in the 80s solidly for many spots across the state. And the moisture, the dew points have really creeped up over the last couple of hours. Now near tropical conditions, Rochester points south as the sea breeze marches ashore and ushers in some moisture off the water itself. So a lot of sun today, but the heat has combined with the humidity to make it feel more soupy outside. You'll notice a lot of spin higher up in the atmosphere. There's a front with this, and as that gets closer, we are expecting numerous chances for rain ahead. So while the heat and the humidity will continue tomorrow, I do think we'll find a decent amount of shower, if not rain activity for the weekend. So this is Futurecast. We'll take you into first thing tomorrow morning. A few clouds will build in overnight tonight, but we are expecting some fog, especially along the Connecticut River first thing tomorrow morning. Downpours and storms begin to fire around noontime up in the North Country. These will begin to build as they go south and east. We're not expecting anything really severe tomorrow, but I think we'll find a few stronger storms in and around the Big Lake and then across southeastern New Hampshire, where I think the highest heat and humidity will build as we go into Friday evening. A stronger gust of wind or two will be the main concern here. Overnight tonight, we'll call it the upper 60s and lower 70s. You factor in the dew points that are higher too, and you'll want to have an AC or a fan running, given it'll be more uncomfortable. And for tomorrow, we'll call it the upper 80s and lower 90s, warmest south and east. And again, that's where the soup will really build in for storms as they march out of the west from Vermont. Saturday, we are expecting a boundary, a frontal boundary, to set up very close to the region. So periods of rain will begin to overspread from the west, get heavier after sunset on Saturday, very heavy rain into early Sunday morning. And the question mark here is to how long does the rain last as we go into Sunday afternoon. Some models like this one do indicate that we'll have rain across the southern half of the state. This could linger for a few hours into Sunday evening and remain rather steady. So we'll watch this closely. Again, this is a low confidence forecast still. As we look into Sunday, we'll iron out these details over the next day or two. But if this boundary remains close and the rain continues to move across southern New Hampshire, the flash flood risk is higher in that shade of yellow. And we're expecting the NASCAR Cup Series at Loudoun on Sunday to be a bit showery, especially at race start. But again, with any improvements, any degradation of the rain activity, that will improve the likelihood that we get the race off without any rain showers as we go deeper into the day on Sunday. We'll watch this closely again for any changes and bring them to you as they become available. We are expecting temperatures to become more seasonable for the start into the middle of next week. Highs only in the upper 70s and low 80s, with more showers and storms expected all the way through Wednesday.